One of the nice features about our graphing calculators is that they have the order of operations already encoded into them. So as long as we're careful on our end as far as how we type in our expressions, it can do all the algebra for us, and it can take care of addition and subtraction and multiplication and division and parentheses and exponents and all that kind of stuff, and take care of the order of operations for us. So probably the most common mistake I see that my students make is with parentheses, especially with division, and we'll make sure to do a few examples of those in particular. So let me get out my calculator here, and I'll show you a few examples. Okay, so our first example here is 5 times 3 minus 2 parentheses 6 plus 1 close parentheses close bracket plus 4 times 7. So basically we just type this in verbatim. Now we don't need a bracket key. A bracket is just another parentheses. So we'll just type this in just exactly as it's written. 5 times the quantity, I'll use a parentheses, 3 minus 2 times, and then open another set of parentheses, 6 plus 1. Okay, I'm going to close that parentheses, and that's closing the 6 plus 1. Then I'll close another parentheses, and this is closing off the bracket. And you should be able to count. There should be the same amount of open parentheses as there are closed parentheses. You have to have one for each. And then plus 4 times 7. And when I push enter, it will take care of the order of operations for me and leave me with an answer of negative 27. Okay, so again, as long as we're careful with our parentheses, it can take care of all the heavy lifting for us. Let's look at this example. This is a very common one where a lot of students make mistakes, right? Because we have division and there's an understood grouping of all the terms in the denominator. We don't literally see a parentheses, but when we take negative 2 times 3 squared divided by 7 plus 2, I don't mean divided by 7 or divided by 2, I mean divided by 7 plus 2, in other words, divided by 9. So we have to add in these parentheses here, even though they're not explicitly written when we write our expression down. Okay, so let's try this one. We'll have negative 2 times 3 squared. And let me show you the incorrect way to begin with. If I wrote divided by 7 plus 2, if I wrote it like this, here's what the calculator is going to do. It's going to apply the correct order of operations as I've written it. It'll take 3 squared and do exponents. Then it'll do multiplication and division from left to right, and it'll take negative 2 times 9 divided by 7 before we add the 2, because it's doing division before addition, as it should. So if we want to do divided by the entire denominator, what I'll need to do is come back here and put parentheses around that 7 plus 2. And then that way, putting it in parentheses will make sure that that's done first and as a whole, because parentheses is higher on the chain of order of operations than division is. So if we type this in and push enter, we should get our correct answer. This is negative 2, negative 2. So negative 2 would be our final answer for this problem. All right, and let's do one more. We'll wrap up with this one. It can handle absolute values as well. Absolute values, you treat them like parentheses as far as grouping goes. You have to do everything inside the absolute values first, just like you would with parentheses. Okay, so let's type this in. We would have 10 minus 3 times. All right, then we have to find the absolute value button. If you look around, there's not an absolute value button, or so it seems. So if you push math, then you actually do have an absolute value button. If you look under the numbers column in NUM, and that's right beside the math column, and this is after you push the math button, by the way, and ABS stands for absolute value. So even though you're not gonna see the bars on older calculators, if you have an old TI-83 or something like that, on some of the newer calculators, they'll actually show you the bars. Okay, so we'll have 3 times the absolute value of 4 times 2 squared minus 30. Okay, and so just make sure everything looks okay. This looks exactly like the way I have it, and we'll push enter, and we get an answer of negative 32. So this will be our final answer. Now before I click off of the calculator here, let me make one remark about exponents. The ones I've done have just coincidentally been squares. If you had a cube, there's not a cube, or well, to if you were doing, let's say, to the fifth power, there's not a fifth power button. So if you wanted, for instance, 2 raised to the fifth power, you would use this caret button right here, and that's how you would do higher powers, like 2 to the fifth, etc. Okay, so our answer for this previous problem, though, was negative 32. So play around with your calculator. It can be a great tool, and it's, again, it's very nice that it has encoded into it already the order of operations.